Hello everyone, welcome to YellowGrey's. In this video, I will show you how to extract data using Document Understanding in UiPath. We have seen load taxonomy, digitized document, and how to classify documents in our previous tutorial. We will learn in this session how to extract data from a document and how to validate those extracted data. Go to the activity search bar, type Document Understanding, drag and drop data extraction scope activity into Workflow Designer panel, provide the input parameter that we defined our previous lesson. In the document path, call the document path variable, that is str_file path. In the document text field, call the document text variable, that is doc_text. In the document object model field, call the document object model variable, that is doc_object_model. In the taxonomy field, call the taxonomy variable which we created in load taxonomy activity, that is json_taxonomy. In the classification result field, call the classification result variable which we created in the classify document scope activity, that is doc_classification_result. Don't forget to add an array of 0 and leave it document type ID. Let's create a variable to store the extraction result. I will name it as doc_extraction_result. We have to drop an extractor here. Go to extractors. You can see three methods of extractors here. Let's go one by one. Let me drag and drop form extractor. This form extractor is used to extract data for fixed template document types. You will see here the endpoint URL. Go to your web page. You can see all types of document endpoint URL on this web page. Let's go back to Studio. In the API key field, we need to provide the API key. I will show you how to get this API key. Go to your Orchestrator page. Click on the admin icon, then click on the license. Then click on Robots and Services page. You will be able to see the section Document Understanding with the API key. If this is your first try, select Generate to generate a new key. Now copy the API key. Go back to UiPath Studio. Paste the API key between double quotes in the API key field. Now click on Manage Templates. You will get this template manager window. Here we are going to start configuring the extractor. Let's have a look at the options we have here. One is Create Template, another is Import. If you already have a template, import it. If this is your first time, click on Create Template. I am configuring for the first time. Let me click the New Template button. You will get Create Template window. Select your document type. I will select the invoice first. Add a template name. Let me add invoice template. Then choose from any of your invoice template documents. Then select OCR engine. I will select the Microsoft OCR engineer. Leave the rest of the fields as it is. Then click on configure button. It will digitize your native PDF to extract data. Read these instructions and click on OK. Wow! Take a look at the left side panel where you can see all of the fields that you defined in the taxonomy manager. And you can see the document appearance in your right side panel. Look at this first option, toggle text view on and off. If you select this option, your image appearance document will be converted as text format. Either you can capture your document field with this text format preview, or image format preview. And you have zoom in, zoom out options here. You can use this option to zoom up, zoom in your document. Then we have the rotate icon here. Using this, you can rotate your document. Then we have a selection mode icon. After clicking this, you will get four types of selection methods. Let's select the token method to capture the document keyword. Keep track of keywords that will be used to identify the invoice document. Drag your mouse on the keyword, it will highlight the keywords in this dot format. Click on this. After clicking this, the extract value button will be activated. If you want to capture additional keywords, press and hold the control key and choose other keywords. Let me select the keywords. After selecting it, click on the extract value button. Look at here, all the keywords captured here. You have to select minimum of 5 words from the first page of the document that uniquely identify it by content and position. Okay, we have selected the keys for the page matching info section. Let's select the remaining field. Go to selection mode, select custom area option. First, let me select the invoice number field. Select on the invoice number. Then in the invoice number field, click the extract value button. Next, we have to extract invoice date. Select on the invoice date. Then in the invoice date field, click the extract value button. Then select on the invoice view date. Then in the invoice view field, click the extract value button. Now we need to select the balance view. Then in the balance view field, click the extract value button. Just take a look at all of the fields that have been captured. You will see that each field has a different color match. We are done. Click on save button. We have configured the invoice document. Let's configure the purchase order document as well. Just follow the same procedure. Click on create template. Select purchase order document, then name the template name. And select any of your purchase order document. Then select Microsoft OCR engine. Then click on configure button. Click on OK. Look at this, in the left side panel we have a field and right side we have a PO document. Just follow the same procedure of invoice document and capture the matching info and the fields. Let me start capture. We have captured all the fields. Click on the save button. For both documents, we have completed the configuration. Now, click on close. Then click on configure extractors. Look at here, we have invoice and purchase order fields. We are going to capture all the fields, so select all the fields. And the left side, you can see the form extractor. You can give a minimum confidence score level here. If you use multiple extractors, you will see each extractor next to it. Click on save. Now we have done the data extraction part. Let's go and validate the extractor data. Go to Document Understanding, under the extractors, drag and drop present validation station. We use this activity just to validate our extractor data. Call the variables which we created earlier. Then create a new variable that to store validate extraction result. let's run the process to check out the validations. Look at this result. This document type matches with this percentage and the fields matches with given percentage. I'm okay with this result. Let me check all these fields. Then click on save. Let's go and check the purchase order document. Provide purchase order file path as an input. Now run the process again. Look at this result. The details were extracted as my expectations. Click on all the checkbox. Then click on save button. I hope you are clear with data extraction, form extractor and present validation station attributes. In our next tutorial, we will see how to export the extracted information for further usage. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe and support. Connect with us for more tutorials.